Welcome back, trainers, and boy, do I have a treat for you today for these Go Battle League Halloween Cup battles. So, we're going to be testing out Shadow Victory Bell. So, here's the thing. I got this during a time where I was not able to TM away frustration, so pretty recently, right? And I was thinking, it doesn't really matter. All we need is Razor Leaf, and we're going to be good to go. So, I just bought a secondary move. We're going to be going with Sludge Bomb, and I'm going to be kind of using this strategy where sure, I'll have to burn a shield in some cases for the lead matchup if they decide to stay in there. Or if I'm able to get to the acid spray, I'm going to be able to do that once they swapped or whenever they take me out. I usually have very little health left after I am finished with that lead matchup, unless it's like an Azumarill or something like that. Then I go down quickly, and then they're going to be kind of forced to swap when I do bring in my next Pokemon because of their defense being bung down so much. So we're also going to be using Shadow Houndoom. And, maybe I should have went with Fire Fang. I feel like there is a lot of situations where Fire Fang would have helped me more, even with the Fire Fang Mawile. Yes, two Fire Fangers. But yeah, we're just going to be messing around here. So yeah, my score is still sitting around 2,700. I'm just a glutton for punishment when it comes to trying to get to rank 10, guys. I just can't help but use these weird and fun teams for you guys and bring you something new and interesting here. We'll get into serious things, I suppose, but I just couldn't help myself but test this out. Now, no Azumarill during this entire battle, but if you're thinking, oh, well, please, you're using Shadow Victory Bell. That takes no skill. I mean, come on. Give me a break. This is a whole Shadow team here. We're having a little fun. We're just going to see what it's going to do. I know Shadow Victory Bell is cheap with Razor Leaf, but it is what it is. We're not using Azumarill. And if you use Azumarill, then hey, I don't really think you have too much place to talk, right? Anyways, let's go ahead and see what we have going on here. Don't really kind of lost in this. It looks like they're going to be giving up that match, okay? So we're going to be able to win a few battles when they still have shields left and even two shields in some cases. So let's see what we have here. We're met with an Azumarill. This is obviously great. We're going to get ready for a swap. They're going to be going into Muk. Now, I'm a little cautious on the swaps. I'm not completely 100% on what people are going to be necessarily safe swapping from an Azumarill because there is so many diverse teams that you could be using currently right now. So, got to be careful there, not just immediately blind swap. So, they're going to be going into that Alolan Muk. We're going to be taking that first Dark Pulse. They did build up to two. We're going to unfortunately have to use a shield here. We do want to potentially win this. And we could have maybe Fire Fanged down, but I'm not going to risk that at this time. We're going to be taking them out with the Power Up Punch. And now we're going to be doing a decent amount of damage. They're bringing in the Marowak. So we're going to be using Shadow Tyranitar for a little bit. And then Shadow Houndoom will be coming in to join the party here. Shadow Tyranitar has been amazing. I love it. And as you can see here, you can take a Bone Club. I had to go over to PvPoke to see what that matchup would do and how much damage it would take when it did get that Bone Club to the face. And as you can see, it can survive one. So I was nervous that it might almost KO, and it's not the case. You can let that go through. So Shadow Victory Bell going down by Ice Beam. We have no shields. Tyranitar going in here. And we're gonna have a double KO, and they had one shield left. That was incredible. If you're wondering why did I not throw my charge, because it was pointless. I had to get to two if I wanted to win that. And going straight with the quick move, I was able to get more in and at least get a double KO, nobody wins. It's kind of ridiculous. I think maybe two wins. Who knows? Anyways, into the next battle, we're met with a Crustle here. So this is kind of an interesting one. I'm not going to be able to have the acid spray right away. We're going to have to build it up a little bit, but they're going to be bringing in a Golbat here, taking us out immediately with that quick move. That is super effective. We're going to be bringing in our Tyranitar here just to build up our energy, and we're just going to town. I was contemplating, should I shield this up? I feel like if they haven't swapped, there's something back there that it does not want to see it. It is a Galvantula, and that's perfectly fine because the Mawile can handle that with ease with Fire Fang, and especially because I was able to get in those smackdowns with the Tyranitar. We're looking beautiful. Now, there's something I want to clear up here. We're going to skip this commentary for this one. And that's the fact that I was mixing up the type resistances, and I'm going to explain what I'm talking about. I said that rock can resist ice and rock, which that's not the case. It's going to be neutral damage. Oops, my bad. I don't know what it is with rock type that I always get confused that it's getting resisted by ice and itself. I don't know why that's always going through my mind, even though I've been playing Pokemon for years. I still always kind of mix it up. You hit two rocks together, it's resisted. I don't know. You throw ice at a rock, it smashes the ice, right? So I'm just thinking kind of elemental. But anyways, there's that explanation. You guys were commenting like crazy, so I just wanted to let you know. My bad, I do make mistakes here on the channel from time to time if you are new. So there is that, right? Anyways, we have the Marowak here, and looks like Tyranitar is making some work out of it. We have no shields, and I got a little nervous using both of those shields up at the beginning. I do believe that's what I did there. They're going to be going in with the Toxicroaker, getting off this Acid Spray to just do that much more damage, just swapping into their Alolan Muk here, and in comes the Toxicroak, and this is definitely not happening. And the reason why I decided to take off the Tyranitar is because of the extreme weakness to fighting, right? I mean, I just wanted to test something out, to be honest with you. I just wanted to see what would happen when I used Houndoom as well. So we're met with another Crustle here. Same thing as before. We're not going to get to the Acid Spray. We're going to have to rely on getting off a few more quick moves when the next Pokemon does come in. So it's not usually the case because a lot of things are going to be able to take me out immediately because we are so glassy with such low health. But we're able to get off that Acid Spray, which is great. So now we can go in here and do that much more damage with our Fire Fang Mawile here. Pretty much like we've gotten off a Power Punch and vamped up our Fire Fang at this point. They're getting a Sludge Wave through and they're going to be swapping into Drifblim. We're going to go right into our Shadow Tyranitar, and this is beautiful. We're going to go ahead and let this go through. Shadow Ball, not very effective. Icy Wind, it's neutral. Better get it right. It's not doing that much damage, but we're so glassy that it hurt quite a bit, but we're still taking it. Saving our shield from this point right here, and that worked out great. They're going to be going down with two shields because we didn't really throw too many charge moves there. Into the next battle, we're met with another Crustle. So here we go again. We're going to just play this out and shield up the first thing and just hope that we can align something after this. Swapping here is going to make it so we're locked in. We might as well just play this one all the way through and burn a shield. So let's see what they're going to come in here with. And it's going to be a Wigglytuff. This is beautiful. And you guys, we're going to see a triple charm user. Oh yeah, we're going to see that here in a minute. Not me, somebody else. Do I win? Do I lose? We'll see. So this is great. We got off the Acid Spray. Did a lot of damage because it's fairy typing. And we're going in here with the Mawile, and we're going to be able to put in work. They have a Tentacruel in the back. Oh, brother. So we went for the Iron Head. It did a decent amount of damage, almost half. We're going in here with the Houndoom. Now we're going to go ahead and use that. We do have Snarl for the quick move, so we can charge a bit quick. And I also wanted coverage up against Alolan Marowak. Honestly, that was my sole purpose. And it wasn't the fact that I just wanted to use this. I did, but I wanted an excuse to completely make it, and it was because I needed a bit of coverage for the Alolan Marowak. So looks like we're not going to be able to win this one, folks. And yes, this team has many weaknesses. It is not a very stable team by any means, and I do not recommend that you use it at all. This is pretty much solely for entertainment purposes only. So don't go out there using something like this and expect to win. This is a very fragile team, and it almost needs everything to align perfectly. You can work your way out of some situations, but if I have, say, I don't know, an Alolan Marowak lead, what I'm gonna have to do is stay in with the Victory Bell, unfortunately, let it farm, and then go in there with the Houndoom and shield it all up, and then just pray that I can line something else up in the back. But if they have an Azumarill back there, it's GG, right? So this team is just blah. It's fun, it's great. As you can see, it's doing things for sure, but it's very iffy. Up here, and if you, all right, so we're gonna have to let this go through, but watch this. Shadow Ball up into the dark type, and it still took us out because we're so glassy. So that is why sometimes I'm gonna be shielding the not very effective charge moves that I'm gonna be getting hit by when I'm using the Shadow Pokemon, because it's still gonna hurt quite a bit because they're just all so glassy. This team right here is just the glassiest. Anyway, taking out the Galvantula with the Fire Fang Mawile, looking great. Here we go. Here's the Triple Charm user. Look at this guy right here. All right, so I was like, okay, this is beautiful. Getting ready for the swap. This is awesome. All right, taking him out. Didn't even have to, use a shield. In comes another one. I'm like, oh, okay. And this is even better. We're going to be able to get off this Acid Spray. And I'm thinking, okay, we have Houndoom in the back. There's no way they're going Triple Charm. Let's just go with our Mawile here. They swap to get the attack or the defense debuff wiped off, and they go into their third one, which is going to be Wigglytuff. And I'm like, okay, I'm going to have to swap here and just kind of, chip away and then get to my charge move here. So that was my win con, I do believe. And we're getting that shield out of them. Perfect. So I needed that to happen. Now we're going to go in here, finish him off with Mawile, and we're going to be able to get to an Iron Head. This is going to KO. So yeah, swapping into that Houndoom there was key. it was very vulnerable for this team, but it still played his position. It's not like it did something great or anything, but we still won. Triple charm, are you kidding me? Into the next battle, we're met with an Azumarill. Beautiful. They're going to be swapping into Galvantula. We're going to go right into our Mawile here, and this is a good matchup for us. Lunge is going to be not very effective. Discharge is going to be neutral and does hurt quite a bit. We're going to be able to take them out there. Fantastic. We still have energy. We're going to be going for an Iron Head onto the Azumarill, which is going to be nice neutral damage. So I wonder what they could have in the back. All right, so you could kind of call teams, I suppose, but honestly, it's just like we described, it's so diverse and there's so many different types of Pokemon they can be using. Sure, there's a meta with a handful of Pokemon, but you know, not everybody's sticking to all that. And yeah, you see Azumarill on pretty much almost every other team, but it is what it is. You know, you can't beat them, join them. So that's pretty much the strategy there. And we're going to be going for Crustle. And this is good. All right, we're going to, you can't shield anything up, but at least we're able to take it down pretty low. And we're going to go in here with Houndoom, very low. And yeah, they're going to be backing out. So we're going to be able to take that win there. Looking good. Let's get it. So taking three wins, folks. I mean, it's not the best. I didn't do too great. You're going to see my score fluctuating as we go between these battles. Seeing the other trainer, you're going to see my score is, yeah, like I said, just hanging around 2,700. That's what happens when you mess around and do kinds of wacky stuff like this. So anyways, into the next battle, we're met with an Azumarill. They're going to be swapping into the Alolan Marowak, and I was waiting for this. So let's go. We're shielding this up. Now, I didn't sim this out to see how well Houndoom can take it, but I know that this thing is, I think, a little glassier than Tyranitar, so we're not going to risk it. So we're shielding up. We're able to take them out. Great. In comes the Azumarill. Now check this clutchness out. We got Fire Blast. We've switched it to Flamethrower, but look at this. We're getting it through. Bam! That was so beautiful. Doing a ton of damage onto that bulky water type Azumarill. So that was great. So they're going to be going for that Ice Beam, swapping into their Wigglytuff. I'm doing a little bit of damage and then swapping into my Mawile here, hoping I can take them out before they get to a charge, and we can. That's great. And at this point, it doesn't really matter because the Azumarill is so low on its health. It doesn't matter if it has like 5 shields because we're just going to be chipping away with our quick move damage here. And we still have Victory Bell in the back, but the thing is, if they build up to 2 Ice Beams, I guess we could have been in trouble, but we're able to finish it off with the Mawile there. Into the next battle, we're met with a Toxicroak. Another interesting one here. We know Mud Bomb is going to be doing a lot of damage to us. Getting a little bit of lag there, that was pretty annoying. That was happening all day, okay? You guys know what it is. I don't even need to go down that route. So we are going to... this is the double shield again. All right, so we're double shielding the Victory Bell. And I was thinking to myself, you know what? I probably just lost this battle because I did that. So we're going to go for the Acid Spray immediately here to lower the defense on whatever that is, Galvantula, and swapping into our Mawile, forcing them to swap into their Crustle. And Mawile still has a good matchup with this, and we can still take a Rock Slide. And we do have the Houndoom in the back, which... You know, Lunge is going to hurt. Discharge is going to hurt, too. So let's see how this does play out. If Houndoom even... it's going to definitely make an appearance. That Rock Slide definitely hurt us quite a bit. Now, the Galvantula did get a bit of farm, and it got a little bit more there. So we're going to go in with our Victory Bell and take it out. You know what I went in there for initially? Just to have them, like, discharge their energy. But they just wanted to... I think they knew they needed to get to, like, 2 because I had a Pokemon in the back. So, into the next battle, we're met with a Shadow Venusaur Razor Leaf. And we swapped into Mawile. They're going to be going into the Alolan Marowak here. So, we're going to be getting a taste of our own medicine from this specific trainer here. You're going to have a smile on your face and laugh. All right, so we're going to go in here with the Shadow Victory Bell. I don't know. I'm just thinking I'm going to have to just play this like, you know, absorb all this charge move. That's exactly what I wanted to do. All right. I wanted them to use all their energy. Great. We're going to go in here with Houndoom and farm down. Beautiful. All right. I don't think I can pull this off, but let's see exactly what we have going on here. So in comes the Venusaur again. What could be in the back that they are bringing out their Razor Leaf user? Anyways, they're in a position to win. I can see this. They can see this. So maybe they just wanted to finish it off with that. But no, they have another Shadow. It is going to be a Shadow Victory Bell. So I just got a taste of my own medicine. Into the next battle, we're met with an Azumarill. They're going to be swapping into a Alolan Muk. And we're going to go right into our Mawile here. So the Sludge Wave is going to be neutral. Well, it's going to hurt. It's doing a lot of damage, right? So we're going to be going for the Power Punch. and just vamping up here. Hopefully they don't get to another charge move, but they're definitely going to be getting to one. We can let whatever they're throwing at us go through. We'll be able to survive no problem and come out of here with energy and hopefully get to an Iron Head depending on what they do bring in here. Probably going to come back with a Zoom Roll. There it is. So we did go for a Power Up Punch. This is going to be doing extra damage because our attack did get raised. So that's great. And we're going to be swapping into our Victory Bell immediately. And they do have a Beedrill back there. Now, this is one of those cases where I was thinking, dang it, if I had Fire Fang on my Houndoom, we would be looking so much better. But I mean, we could all say that for so many different situations. Oh, if I had this move on this Pokemon, I would have won this, right? But I'm just curious as to how it would have worked if I did have two Fire Fang users. But if I did run into an Alolan Marowak, I did check out the Sims, and Houndoom Shadow will not be able to win that, even with the Dark Charge move. So Snarl is the way to go, because if I didn't, then this team would get hard countered by that Pokemon easy and nothing would be able to stand up to it. Anyways, into the next battle here, we're going to be met with a Wigglytuff. This is great. Another Charm user. Fantastic. Let's see if they want to swap out. They're going to be going into Quillfish, and I'm thinking to myself, we'll stay right here because Mawile can handle the Wigglytuff Charm. So we're just going to stay right where we're at. I expected that to be that charge move, but I just shielded it up anyways. I knew it was not very effective, but we need to keep our health as much as possible. So we're trying to get this darn acid spray. Did you see that lag? We're up against a confusion user. Time is of the essence. I can't stand the lag when, you know, when you get taken out in like two quick moves, especially from that thing. So luckily we're able to actually get that off. We're swapping into a Mawile, which is beautiful, taking out that steel and bug type with ease. In comes the Wigglytuff here. They still have two shields, so let's see how this does play out. Houndoom, it can't do it. So we're gonna go in here with the Victory Bell and just do as much damage as possible. And they still have two shields. That Wormadam has no health and we're taking them out. So the Houndoom isn't really doing too much for us. It can go up against the Alolan Marowak, but other than that, sure, it can hit other things pretty hard, but it's just there. It's just doing things to kind of protect us from that Alolan Marowak. So anyways, let's go ahead and hop into the next battles and see what we have for our opponent's Pokemon. It is going to be a Sableye purified. So we're going to go ahead and just stay in this fight here. I'm simply going to shield up the first charge, and we're going to be able to simply farm down. If they swap, we'll go ahead and make a swap according to what they go into, and it's going to be a Wigglytuff, so we're going to go ahead and stay right where we're at. Go for this Acid Spray and get a shield or do a decent amount of damage. They're going to be shielding it up. We're lowering that defense, and they survive with like 1 or 2 HP. Go ahead in there with the Mawile, because we know we can hang with the Sableye, so they're going to reveal their last Pokemon here. Or they're going to go back in with Sableye. We're going to be gaining a little bit of energy, and I wanted to catch a Foul Play, but I got nervous and thought it could be Power Gem, and I used my shield, so we used our last shield. That's not good. They have a Galvantula in the back, so I'm going to be building up to two Foul Plays here. Let's see if we can get both these shields, folks. If you did enjoy this video, give it a big thumbs up. Subscribe if you're new, and I'll be keeping you up to date on everything Pokemon Go, and we're going to be able to take the win. Take care.